Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. My name is Alice and today we're going to go through my favorite yellow eyeshadows and makeup products, let's say, in general. Yellow has been an obsession of mine since, last fall, and it's really booming. Everybody's wearing yellow. Yellow is everywhere. I absolutely love it. In fact, the room next door actually has a yellow wall, and I have so many yellow clothes in my closet. But starting from the beginning, yellow really came to my attention this fall when Anastasia Beverly Hills released the Subculture palette. This was the palette that put yellow on the radar for me. The color scheme here is very 70s. It is very fall, and these two yellows really started my obsession with the color in makeup, let's say. I have to say, these are two of the yellows that I still today prefer. Edge is a more mustardy type of shade, whereas New Wave is more on the orangey side of yellow. Absolutely beautiful shades, very buttery, very pigmented. As you know, Subculture, you have to actually just be a little bit careful on how you apply it. But in general, the lighter shades are very easy and buttery and blendable. So this was the beginning of my yellow obsession. And I still use this palette a lot, so it's definitely and my favorites. These are, though, not the first yellows I ever had. I had purchased, thanks to my friend Julia from Glitters for Breakfast, she put me on to Makeup Geek Chickadee. This was the first yellow toned shade that I ever had in my collection, and this is a very wearable, very easy shade of yellow. It's more on the indeed orangey side, more ochre, and those are the shades that are a little bit more present in nature and a little bit easier to wear, I would say. But then from there you can go in infinite directions. I put together here a little palette to go through the shades that I am loving right now. This is not all the yellows I have. I have a few more yellows, but these are the ones that work well, transfer well to the eyes, and it is very important, actually. So the pigment, the yellow pigment, is actually quite difficult to get to work properly, especially in these bright formulations. So there are a few shades that I would not recommend. Among these, the yellow from Suva Beauty that I had for a while, then I decluttered because it wouldn't transfer well to the eyes. But the two bright yellows that I do recommend, first and foremost, the best bright yellow on the market, this is Sugar Pill Butter Cupcake. It's a true yellow, period. It shows up very well on the eyes, and it is a bright shade, let's say. This is not something I use on a daily basis, but definitely something to make more colorful and poppy looks, let's say. Here next to it, this is actually a blush from Inglot. It's definitely not less pigmented than the other shades just because it's a blush, and this was a limited edition, I think, from a series called Fibulous. I don't know exactly how to pronounce that, but a beautiful, beautiful shade, the blush number 18. And these are my very bright, very true yellows. Up here you find a few others. This one here is an eyeshadow from Neve Cosmetics. This is called Tonka, and Tonka is actually what I'm wearing on my cheeks today. I picked this up because it's a bigger pan, and in my experience, Neve Cosmetics eyeshadows can be very easily used as blushes because the formula is very friendly, it's very blendable, and they're not extremely pigmented. However, this is very pigmented, so you really need a light hand, but you can see you can wear yellow blush. I prefer to wear this type of yellow rather than the Inglot type of yellow because it's more, it's more earthy toned, it's more close to nature, and it's more orange, so it's a little bit easier to wear, but it works well with any yellow eye look. Then by Makeup Geek, we talked already about Chickadee. And for shimmer, I recently picked up, and I don't know what I was doing, Fortune Teller. This is a beautiful, beautiful true yellow. And you can see it on my eyes today. It's what I have on my lid and on my inner corner. This is a foiled eyeshadow, and it's really a pop of color. I can really, really recommend it. In the pan, it looks a little bit scary and a little bit more lime, but as you can see on the eyes, it translates to beautiful bright yellow. And up here then, the last three are from ColourPop. The first one here is called Tiki. This was part of their summer collection last year, I believe. And it's what I have on my crease, on my transition shade today. This is not the most pigmented yellow eyeshadow, but it's still a little bit less bright than the true yellows. And since it's not too pigmented, it works well in the crease, it blends well. I definitely like using it. It's a very nice transition shade for any time you want to put a little bit of yellow in your look. Two Birds is a bright shimmer, but you can use it a bit easier, let's say, than Fortune Teller. It's again a more wearable yellow, a more earthy tone. And finally, Paper Tiger. This is definitely something you can wear on a daily basis. It's definitely more mustardy, a little bit more muted of a yellow. And these shades are all absolutely gorgeous. I am today wearing, in, as I said, Tiki, Chickadee all over my lid. Then I put a thousand things on top, so you can't really see it, but it's in the look. I use some browns to deepen the look because I like to wear all yellow, but you need to still give 3D structure to your look. And as I said, Fortune Teller on the lid and inner corner. One more mention to a yellow paste palette that this I am a little bit iffy at talking to you about, but it is something I really enjoy using. The Kat Von D drama really hit me when with the whole anti-vax situation she got herself into. And unfortunately, just before that came to be, I had to just purchase her 10-year anniversary palette. And this palette spoke to me. And even though I knew it was limited edition and it wouldn't have been very useful for my channel, but these colors were absolutely gorgeous and up my alley, and especially, of course, the yellows here. I created multiple looks. If you follow me on Instagram, you've seen them with exactly this combination of color. This one, two, three, and this brown. I had this as a transition, this all over the lid. This is let's say shimmer on top, it's a beautiful glitter, and the dark to deepen the crease. Today I tried to reproduce exactly the look I do with this palette, with the rest of my eyeshadows, mainly because I don't want to support Kat Von D. I don't want to recommend to you to go buy Kat Von D, just because I do not support someone who is anti-vax. I cannot, it's just against who I am as a scientist and as a person. But I honestly have to say, I have the product, I will keep using it, and I enjoy the looks I can get with it. However, as you can see, you can achieve the same thing with eyeshadows that are not contributing to spreading deadly diseases in the world. Let's put it that way. One small mention to also a discontinued product. This is ColourPop Punch. This is one of their gel eyeliners. And yeah, very sadly, these are not made anymore. And unfortunately, they were some of the best products ColourPop had. And then of course, in front of my eyes, and I forget to talk about it, we have MAC Chrome Yellow. This was a present from a very good friend of mine, Francesca. And this is a bright matte yellow. It's not the most pigmented of the lot, but it's definitely a true yellow, and you can use it in the crease. Because it's not too pigmented, it will not do the effect of a clown. It's nice and easy to blend into the skin. And that is also kind of the advantage of using a yellow compared to using, let's say, a blue or some very other crazy colors. Yellows, you can actually blend into your skin tone quite easily. And yeah, I don't know if this is still available, if you can still get this. I thought they discontinued it. So this is also, though, a very nice eyeshadow if you can get your hands on it. With this, we reached the end of my favorite yellow eyeshadow and makeup products, let's say. I hope you liked it. I am super obsessed with yellow. I was gonna wear a yellow shirt, and then I was like, but yellow on yellow on yellow on yellow on yellow. Maybe it's a little bit too much, so I went for black. I hope that's okay. I also really like pairing a yellow eye look with a bright red lip. I love wearing my bright blue electric blue dress because it goes well with the primary color scheme. I really like it. Also, I don't know if you noticed, I am obsessed with yellow in my house as well. That is a nice pineapple, yellow pineapple base. But yeah, I guess, guys, that is it. Let me know if you're as obsessed with yellow as I am. I have a few friends who are. Talking to you, Letizia. I know you're obsessed with yellow as much as I am. And let me know if you actually wanted me to do something like this with the rest of my yellow objects, house, bags, and clothing. I have a lot of yellow stuff that I love. I would love to do that. Let me know if you're interested in a comment down below and I'll get to it ASAP. And for the rest, signing off, I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.